that you please comply with the following. There is to be no talking objection throughout the performance. If you need to leave, please do so with your musical numbers as you on the side exits only. Ladies and gentlemen, please remove all hats and headgear and enjoy tonight's recital. Next piece, and it was conducted
by our other trombone professor, Dr. Megan Booten. She also helps and she teaches and she helps direct the choirs and coaches ensembles. This next piece from Fire's Dark Gaze is Green Ensemble. And this one is also conducted by Dr. Booten. It's written by a gentleman by the name of Andrew Markle, and he's written countless pieces for trombone ensemble. He wrote a huge work for trombone concerto and band. Fabulous person. He's actually going to write our trombone choir, who's going to the Midwest Clinic in Chicago. He's going to write us a brand new piece to close. It's going to be really, really awesome to hear this. I'm excited to hear that. So we should be getting it soon. He told me soon, so I'm excited. So I hope you all enjoy the concert. We have a little bit of some new music. We have some old band music, some choral music, and every piece that you hear has a great difficulty for every single ensemble. We wanted to push the envelope this year, this semester, and they did a fantastic job, you know, despite all the COVID circumstances. So I'm really, really proud of all the students, and also Dr. Wooten for helping me out, and we work together to teach everybody. So I hope you have a great time, and I hope everybody here enjoys it, and I hope everybody online also. So here is the next piece from Fire's Dark Days.
Thank you. for everybody watching online, thanks for checking us out. We hope that you're enjoying it so far. The next piece on the program is Ave Maria by Franz Beagle. Just a little bit of background about this piece. Beagle was actually a director of a parish in Bavaria, and he ran essentially a men's choir there, so you'll really hear that in the way this piece was written. It's transcribed for trombones, and it really translates well from men's choir to trombones. In this piece, you'll hear the opening is basically a prayer, and the text that this piece was taken from is essentially a prayer that includes the Ave Maria or the Holy Mary. So you'll see that we essentially have two choirs working together here. One is a sort of smaller choir that could essentially have been three soloists. We doubled it, and then we have our full ensemble that'll complement that. So we hope you enjoy the next piece, Ave Maria.
Thank you.
while we are switching, we'll get a little preview of the next piece. We have to be a little creative in how we move on and off of stage and how we move in spaces, just to be cautious. So the next piece you'll see is we're going to be doing just an octet. This is Anarchy, and by Seth E. Brown. It was written for a competition in 2017, a competition held by a trombonist and social media, popular social media personality, Christopher Bill. So he held this competition, and this piece was actually the third place winner. So you'll see this piece is a group of eight, so it's one of our octets. And what they've been doing is essentially working by themselves and working hard on their own to put this piece together. And I've been coaching them some, but they've done a lot of the time on this, the majority of the time on this on their own. So that's one of the really nice things that we can do with these groups is let them work and come together and do a performance basically on their own for you. So they will be up next doing Anarchy by Seth Brown.
Thank you.
Okay, so let's talk a little bit about, you saw the larger ensemble perform Ave Maria. Now I'm going to conduct a piece entitled Corkso's Grange from Percy Grainger's marvelous band work entitled Lincolnshire Poesy. It's one of my favorite pieces within a piece. I actually arranged this, and I arranged this when I was 23, I believe. And I brought it out to the students and we played through it and I hated it. I hated my own arrangement. I hadn't heard it in a long time. So I went that night and stayed up really late and fixed it, added some parts and did some things. And I remember just yelling at my 23-year-old self, why did I do that with this? So it was nice to kind of revisit an old piece and fix it and make it sound nice and have the students perform it. So you saw that we had two larger ensembles. They're about 18. And the ensembles, what we did this year is typically we have 36. Like we have a full choir. If you've been to choir, to Mon choir concerts before, we have a full choir. But of course with COVID restrictions, we decided to make everybody safe to cut it in half. So what we ended up doing is having a split full choir. So when we have auditions, you know, we have first chair went to one choir, second chair went to the other, third went to one, fourth. So everything is equally distributed. And we did that for educational purposes, so the younger students got a chance to play for the older students. And they got to interact, because typically they do that when they have a full choir. So now you're going to hear, you heard Ave Maria earlier, a nice vocal piece. Now you're going to hear a nice band piece entitled Corkso's Grange, and I hope you like this one.
Thank you.
Next piece is going to be performed by our Blue Octet. and how we kind of have the groups grouped together. Because like I said earlier, we have auditions and we kind of group. We have two octets and they form one piece, and then, or one ensemble, and then another two octets form another piece. So you're going to be hearing these next three pieces are going to be the pretty much top 16 that we have here in the studio. The next piece is entitled Entrada, and it's another piece that we coach. They work on their own. You make sure they're doing what they're supposed to do, and then like true chamber music, no conductor. And this is actually a really good piece. The last time we performed this was at the American Trombone Workshop in 2014, long time ago. And we had a great time, we had a great show, and they're going to perform this from memory. And it's by a great composer by the name of Stephen Berhaus. He's written many pieces for trombone ensemble, brass, everything. And I tend to use his pieces because they fit so well with the trombone idiom. And this is a fantastic piece that's been recorded by a great trombone player, Ben Van Dyke. He actually did a multi-track recording of it, of himself playing on it. It's a fantastic piece, and I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
Okay, so the next group is the South Texas Trombone Sound. It's our top octet here at the college. And the piece they're going to be performing is a piece entitled Osteoblast by Derek Bourgeois. He's a prolific composer, written a lot of pieces for bass trombone, trombone, band works, brass band works. And his trombone works are on another level, specifically the trombone octet. He has two of them, the Scherzo for Libre, which is a very difficult piece, and this is another one, Osteoblast. These two pieces that Derek Bourgeois had written are probably one of the hardest trombone octets written. It's a great piece. It has great everything. Every part's got something lovely for them. And Joey has the alto trombone, which is the alto. He played it in Hawkesville Grange. That's his alto. And so as they get set up, I hope you enjoy Osteoblast.
Thank you.
for our final work, I'll talk about that in a second. First, I'd like to thank everyone for coming. It's nice to have a live audience, and also for everybody on the internet land at YouTube watching our channel or watching the School of Music channel. Thank you for chiming in. It's been an interesting year, as everyone can kind of say, like, yep, it's been interesting. But it's still been fun. We've been trying to move forward, doing some things, doing some challenging things, so that they still get a good education, productive, learning things, whether lessons or an ensemble, and I know all the faculty here are doing the same thing to kind of to watch after the students and, of course, watch after their safety, and also, of course, to keep them learning about music. So before the next piece, I'm going to say a goodbye to my graduate assistant, Mr. Ronald Brown. Mr. Ronald Brown, he's going to be graduating for the master's degree. He would help out with a trombone choir, he helped out with a jazz band, he helped me make coffee, we did a lot of stuff, we talked about, you know, his next plan, so we're going to miss him very dearly, so thank you for the time you spent with us. I wish we had another year. I've heard kind of COVID robbed us a little bit of some things, but we did the best we can, and we're going to miss him very dearly. So thank you, Ronald, for everything. We appreciate it. American Overture. I once heard this piece when I was about probably 12 years old. My father had a record of his UIL music, and I was like, oh, what's this? And I played it, and there were a couple of pieces. Man of La Mancha was one, and American Overture was one of the other ones. And I thought, what a cool piece. Later on, as I went through school, I found out that there was an arrangement by a friend of mine, David Wilborn, the composer. He actually teaches at A&M College Station. He's fantastic, he's a bass trombonist, he writes a lot of great music at all different levels, and this is a piece that he transcribed for trombone ensemble entitled American Overture by Joseph Wilcock Jenkins, and it's just a band staple, so I hope you enjoy it. Thank you so much for coming to tonight's concert, and hope to see you again very soon. Thank you so much.